At least three metro counties are being urged to start processing absentee ballot requests right now to avoid any backlogs.
Well, there will be a special election in DeKalb, Fulton, and Clayton counties to fill Congressman John Lewis's seat. And some DeKalb voters feared their ballots wouldn't come in on time after a confusing email was sent out by elections officials. CBS 46's Haley Mason has updates to clarify the mistake.
It was this email that set off confusion for absentee voters in DeKalb. It indicated their absentee ballot requests wouldn't be processed until late September. A concerned voter contacted the ACLU.
We've had a record number of people requesting absentee ballots right now, and if they wait until September 29th to do this, people may not get their ballots in time.
State law says elections officials must mail or issue absentee ballots to applicants no less than 45 days before the November election, no greater than 49 days. That means applications should be mailed or issued starting September 15th, not waiting until the special election is over on September 29th.
I just want to try to clear up the confusion.
DeKalb's election chair tells me that email was originally drafted when they were waiting on more info from the state.
The email in question was an automatic response. And I think it has been changed, but what we were trying to do was to let the voters know that your ballot request has been received.
Tillman says since August 14th, DeKalb has already processed around 70,000 absentee ballot requests for the general election, and they're not waiting to process applications.
We're ready for September, and we will be ready for the November elections.
I reached out to elections officials in Clayton County as well as Fulton since they both had that special election in September. They tell me they are not waiting to process applications. They're receiving them for November, they're receiving them for September, and they're processing them all at the same time. Reporting in DeKalb County, Haley Mason, CBS 46 News.